looking at it. Just think about tangs, huh? Just think about tangos. Piano. Hannah. Okay, so this morning, yesterday morning, I don't think I got anything yesterday morning, but I got a good one the day before, and then this morning. Well, and then I had this other awesome one, but I can make that into a separate one, but that one was really good. Haven't talked about that one yet, but the one I had this morning, which I have about 5 month, where I'm having this love affair with exes or whatever. And oh my God. And it's like I was at, you know, that person's house in the town, you know, where they're originally from or whatever. And the scenario, the house was a little different. But, I mean, we were just, like, in bed, and we were just smooching and smooching and smooching and smooching, like, forever and ever and ever and ever. And I get a lot of experiences like this that just last forever, you know, like, the romance and everything. And, I mean, I don't know how the aliens do it. I don't know how Joel does it, but it's, like, so virtual reality. And then it stays with me, like forever. Like, after I wake up and everything. But I get scenarios like this, well, sometimes 10 times a month. So this was just another one of those romance scenarios. And the funny thing is, finally, I got out of the bed after many, 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 many hours. And I started walking around, you know, the house. And I went down a big hallway. And I know where Joe got that from, because this ex-person was trying to sell her house and everything. And the pictures on the internet, it's like everything was cleaned out. And so when I looked in the living room, you know, everything was just cleaned out. The whole house was empty. So I guess... she put her shit in storage or whatever, because she knew she's going to sell it and then move to San Antonio or whatever. But anyway, so it was kind of funny. So, but like I said, in the scenario, it was kind of different. I mean, it was laid out a little bit different. But this big old hallway, pretty wide hallway, there wasn't hardly anything in the hallway. Like, big old hallway right here, hardly nothing in it. But so, after we had all this romance, let me think where the bed was. And the scenario, well, actually, in the scenario, it was kind of hard to tell. But, like, the bedroom was, like, over here. And then, eventually, I started traipsing down this way, down this big old wide hallway of the house. And it was pretty much empty. Nothing sitting around or anything. Except when I looked down on the ground. I mean, on the floor. There was these two big old pans. And I can't remember what was laying on top of this one's big old cookie. Not pans. Cookie sheets. Like big old cookie sheet type of things. I can't remember what the hell was on that one. But on this one, it was like 40 pieces of like big O, like rolls, like I mean big O yeasty rolls, like 40 of them. And I was like, and I knew what the deal was. I knew that after she would order pizza, you know, like it was kind of like she ordered pizza all the time, and then they would give her like, you know, like 3 or 4 rolls for free or whatever. And she just didn't like them, so she just kind of threw them on this cookie sheet. And later on, she was just gonna, you know, give them to the birds or whatever. But that was kind of funny. And I can't remember what was on this cookie sheet, but there were 2 of them, and there was some kind of food item, and I can't remember what it was. But this was all like rolls, just all these rolls, like 40 of them, like pretty big rolls, kind of oblong. I mean, there's tons of them. And like I said, at first I was like, okay, why does she have all those rolls? And then I started thinking, I knew that she didn't like them. So she just put them on this cookie sheet, you know, wait until you eventually give them to the animals or the birds or whatever. I thought that was kind of funny. But, and it's really weird. And then it's like you'll be having romance with somebody. I mean, and it's all very weird and very physical and stuff in the scenario. And then sometimes afterwards, like, the alien will make you start having thoughts of, like this other person that you sort of are, like, when the scenario, it was, you know, like physically making out, and then later on, it's like, Joel will make you have thoughts of, like, another person where it's just kind of, like, you're thinking about, like, mentally, you know, already thinking of, like mental thoughts, like, you want to make out with that person. It's really weird. But, yeah, it was just really strange. And let me think of if there's anything else. Oh, I'm sure there was. I've probably already forgotten a lot because I didn't hurry up and write everything down, like, when I woke up. But, let me think. Because I know there was some... Okay, hold on. But there really wasn't a whole lot, except just... We were just making out... for hours and hours and hours and hours and hours and hours. Okay, hold on. Let me think. Shit, hold on. Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. I say, I told you. You know, I'll fucking forget. Oh, my God. Okay, all the shit came back to me. Okay. After we fucked basically, but we weren't really fucking, just, you know, making out for hours and hours and hours and hours and hours and hours. And after I observed the cookie sheet, the 2 big, you know, silverish cookie sheets were just sitting there on the, and it wasn't carpet, it was like laminate flooring. And in her house, she did have a bunch of, she had tile in the kitchen, carpet in the bedrooms, but laminate flooring in the big old dining room and both living rooms. It was nothing but laminate flooring. And, well, the hallway, shit, I can't. The hallway was carpet in real life. But in this scenario, it was like laminate flooring. And, okay, another part of the scenario, let's see, I had walked over to, like, where the couch was, and I looked down and I saw this. Oh my God, I don't know how the aliens do it, but this dog was the weirdest looking dog. It was a dog that she had, and she always had dogs. Pretty much, she had a cat before, a long time ago, before I knew her. But, you know, she pretty much always had dogs. So she had this dog, but it was the weirdest looking dog ever. Because I was looking at it, and I'm like, is that a goat, or is that a lamb, is that a, I couldn't tell what the hell it was, but basically, it was a dog, and it looked like a cross between a goat, and a sheep, and a dog. It was the weirdest looking dog, you know, the face and everything. And I don't know how the aliens do it, but they can make things, make creatures look really, really, really weird. So there was this dog looking thing. I mean, it was a dog, but it was a cross between, like, 2 to 3 other animals. I mean, that's basically what it looked like. Like, it was so weird looking. The face and everything. But it was a sweet dog. And it was kind of cream colored. It was cream colored. And I reached down there to pet it and everything. And that part went on for a long time. And I know I'm probably forgetting a few things. The making out went on for hours and hours and hours and hours. That part went on for quite a while. Me sitting there talking about the dog, petting the dog, and staring at the dog and seeing how weird it looked, the face and everything. And, okay, hold on. Let me think of this last part with the, the turtle. And hold on. I'm about to forget it. Okay, hold on. There's the red ear slider. Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. How can I forget this part? So basically, I realize now I remembered everything of this scenario. Except for you know, maybe a few conversations and stuff that we had, you know, when I was sitting there staring at the dog and all that. Okay, the last part of the scenario, and we were, it doesn't really matter, but the bed was, like that, and then, like, our heads were right there. So our feet was, how do you make a foot? I don't even know. Our feet was right here. And then, like I say, that went on. So our feet were facing that way. And that went on for hours and hours and hours and hours and hours and hours. And like I say, and then eventually I got up because I wanted to go observe. And I know, let's see. Yeah, we were going to order pizza again. I remember, you know, her talking about that, and we were going to order pizza again, or we were about to order pizza, but in the scenario, you know, it never did come or whatever. And then I started moseying and, you know, observing her house and everything. And I was visiting for whatever reason. Why do I keep hearing the cats eating? And then I look over and then there's nobody over there. Is that Shiloh or Tango? Well, Shiloh's over there now eating. Okay, so the last part, oh yeah, oh, I know why I just said that. Remember I just said that I think I'm forgetting, I might be forgetting a few words and stuff that, you know, when I was talking about the dog and everything, when I saw her dog and she was over here somewhere, like Brenda was over here somewhere. I remembered everything. But anyway, so... the last part of the scenario, I look down at the dog. I look really, really close. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Okay. I look really, really close on the dog. And I'm like, is that a flea? And I was like, wait a minute. That's a tick. It clearly was, you know, at first I thought it was a flea. And it was a big old, I don't know how to draw a tick. But it was clearly, it all of a sudden got, you know, bigger. You know, and that's when I was like, no, that's a tick. And so I was, you know, trying to tell Brenda, oh, it's a tick. You know, I see a big old tick. And, but at first I thought it was a flea. And then all of a sudden, okay, this is the weird part. Then all of a sudden, a red ear slider just came out of thin air. I mean, just came out of thin air, like it manifested in thin air over here somewhere in thin air, just psh. And gobbled up the tick and ate the tick. But yeah, so, well, thank God all this fucking came back to me because I was just about to forget 50% of it. But anyway, so yeah, well, luckily I remembered everything. But anyway, except for, I can't remember what kind of food was, but there was definitely something there, some kind of food, but I can't remember what that was. And this was nothing but bread. And like I say, the bread was just all kind of oblong, low, you know, small little rolls like rolls, the oblong like rolls, and there's a lot of them. I mean, it was all filled up, like 30-40 rolls, and I had thoughts of like I wanted to, you know, get down there and eat some of them, you know, but I knew they were probably kind of stale. But that was really cool. The redder slider just came out of nowhere and just gobbled up, and it was so virtual reality. Like I saw the redder slider like psh, you know, eat the whole tick and everything. It was all, you know, pretty much virtual reality and everything. Yeah, so anyway, that experience was kind of cool. That other one, that was really good, I thought. I'll talk about that in a separate video. Because that one was, like, really awesome, too. Because I love it when I know that I'm in an altered state and everything. And I'm trying to, like, look up there. And I'm like, okay, I know. I got to remember this. Because when I wake up, I want to make sure I remember. And so I just kept studying the sign, the signs and the address and blah, 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 blah. And so when I woke up from that experience, I hurried up and wrote everything down. But anyway, so these two that I'm talking about, I didn't. But anyway, luckily I remembered everything. Okay, so then I had this other experience, which was really fun too. And I've had plenty more, but I don't try to remember all of them. I mean, I can if I wrote them down and everything, or just a couple sentences down or whatever. Okay, so then it was like 2 days ago. I went to eat at this I don't really want to call it a Chinese restaurant, but an Asian. It was mainly an Asian restaurant, but it sort of served India food as well, or India type of food. And of course, I did have, you know, redder sliders on the brain and everything before that experience I had this morning. And, you know, ticks, too, because I'm always getting the ticks off the cats. And so, I mean the fleas off the cats. Okay, so, and this was a fun experience, too. Okay, so, I was in this restaurant for a long time. Long, 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 long time. Hours and hours and hours and hours. Asian restaurant, basically. That also served India type of food. And Joel didn't tell me what the name of the restaurant was called or anything. He could have named it something if he wanted to. So basically, I was there like by myself, but there was some other people I was having other customers that were eating too, that I was having some conversation with, like over here. There were some tables over here, and I eventually sat over here, and I was talking to some other customers, like, well, what kind of sauce do you like, and blah, 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 blah. Okay, so, and I was eating, what I ate was, it was almost kind of like, what's it called? Cashew chicken. What I was eating was almost kind of like cashew chicken. It was big breaded piece of chicken. And the sauce, and I just kept eating it forever and ever. I just sat there and ate it forever and ever and ever and ever. Okay, but before I started eating the food forever and ever and ever and ever, like for whatever reason, I went over here and I walked to one of the workers, one of the Asian, she was Asian, one of the Asian, the chefs basically that worked at the restaurant. And she was facing that direction. Standing up, and the kitchen was over here, and it was like she was, you know, about to cook or whatever, and then I was asking her questions and stuff about the food items and all that, and then at one point she said, well, if we don't cook it right, like, our manager will like And she did the motions of like having this can of hairspray, like psh, and she started like acting like, you know, she was squirting it down her ears and spraying it down her ears and all over her face and stuff, like a can of hairspray. And I did have, I can't remember when I had hairspray on the brain, but I did have that on the brain a few days or whatever previous to this experience. And so she started doing these motions like, well, if we do something bad and don't cook everything right, you know, the man, their bosses basically will, and which happened to be a female, because I had it in my brain that I knew that it was a female, would take this hairspray and like squirt it down their ears and all over their face and stuff. And I started thinking, like, in my head, like, wow, like that's got to burn or something. But in the scenario, like, nothing seems odd. Like, that doesn't seem, like, in the scenario, it didn't seem like that was an odd thing for somebody to do, for a boss or a manager to do that. But then after you wake up and everything, you think, like, that's fucking weird, you know? You know? After you wake up and everything. Okay, so that part was kind of funny. And I can't remember exactly the questions I was asking her, but I was talking to her and asking her questions about the food items and stuff like that. And so eventually, I ordered, that's the dish I ordered. It was kind of like cashew chicken. And it was so good, and I was just sitting there eating it forever and ever and ever. Oh, okay. So when the server came up, and I forgot a part. Okay, so when I started looking at the Asian woman, the worker, the employee, chef, basically, cook, basically, I looked down at her hands, and she was holding this, what do you call it, a bottle of, or a glass jar of, like, that orangey, creamy, yummy, spicy sauce. And I was thinking in my head, okay, I want that. I want that on my dish. She was holding it, you know, about 7 inches tall, you know, 3 inches, you know, wide. And I knew that I wanted that. Joel knows that I like that sauce that I used to eat at the sushi restaurant, or the restaurant. So I knew that I wanted that, and I told her I wanted that. So eventually, after I ordered the it wasn't cashew chicken, but it was kind of like cashew chicken. I sat down forever and ever and just was eating it and eating it and eating it and eating it. And it was really, really, really good, but I didn't have my sauce that I wanted. So then, eventually, I started talking to this other woman, this white woman. And I was like, I want that sauce. I want that orangey sauce. And she's like, well, just ask for it again and they'll come give it to you. So then I told like the server again that I wanted that orangey spicy sauce, creamy spicy sauce. And, you know, and I know also where Joel got that from was India restaurants, because it used to be the dish I would get had that yummy orangey spicy creamy sauce or whatever that I used to order. So then the server was, I mean, so then eventually I just waited forever and ever and ever and ever, and it was never brought to me. But I told her that, you know, I told her that was the good sauce and that's what I wanted. And it just took him forever to give it to me. And basically I never got it, but the server said that they were going to, you know, give it to me and everything. And, you know, the aliens do that a lot. Like they'll, create a scenario. And you're about to have sex with somebody, but then you never have sex with them. Shit like that. Or you're about to, like, you're playing soccer and you're trying to kick the ball. And it's like, ugh, like, you can't kick the ball. You can't kick it. You can't kick it. But like I say, 9 times out of 10, I have the experiences where I am actually having all this romance and shit physically with the person in the scenario. He doesn't really do that very often where, you know, like I always pretty much 90% of the time get intimate with the person. Okay, so anyway, instead of, you know, like, I mean, and maybe 5% of the time, you know, have a scenario where, actually I haven't had one of those in a long time where it's kind of like you, like in the scenario, you want to be with somebody, but yet you never get with them. That's rare. I mean, it's been a long time since I've had one like that. nine times out of 10, you know, 10 times a month, I'm having all this sex and romance with people, like physically in the scenario, so to speak, for virtual reality wise. Okay, so then I was telling her, oh, this sauce is good, that sauce is good and everything. But it was still good. I mean, I was tasting it and eating it and everything. And I was eating it and eating it and eating it. It was so good. It tasted just like cashew chicken with whatever sauce I had. It was really, really, really good. But like I say, I never was brought that yummy, orangey, creamy sauce that she was holding in her hands. That jar of, you know, that yummy sauce. Okay, so anyway, so, and after I started eating, and I mean, as I was eating and everything, and the white woman was over here sitting down that I started talking to, and she started telling me, like, what's good or what's not good or whatever. And then all of a sudden, it was like on the windowsill, like, there was like a windowsill over here, and all of a sudden, like, I see these, like, display of, like, fake, you know, I guess they were plastic flowers, and except it had all this rice, all of this fake rice was attached to it, and I told that woman, I was like, oh my God, are they gonna serve me rice, because I knew I was allergic to rice. Because it's gluten. It's gluten. It's not gluten-free. Rice is not fucking gluten-free. Corn is not fucking gluten-free. Oatmeal is not fucking gluten-free. It's all fucking gluten, you dumb motherfuckers. Okay, now get that fucking straight. Before I pound it up your ass. Okay, so anyway. I'm not talking to my audience. I'm talking to dumb fuck food industry and the doctors. So, there was all this rice attached to these fake display of flowers, colorful flowers, and on the windowsill, and these, you know, flower pots. And so I told that woman, I'm like, oh my God, they're gonna serve us like that all that rice. And, you know, because like I say, I knew in the scenario I was allergic to rice, and I knew in real life I was allergic to rice. So in the scenario, I also knew I was allergic to rice. And so here's the sign. GF, not gluten-free. No grains are gluten-free. Nada. Okay, so it's all a scam or whatever. Okay, so anyway, and it just really pisses me the fuck off. And I mean, I only got fucking pissed off because I knew I had celiac disease, and I gave up the wheat, and I kept eating fucking gluten-free food with rice and corn in it, and then all of a sudden I started having the same fucking symptoms, and then so I had to figure it out on my own. You know, you can't eat corn and rice, and then I knew I can't eat any motherfucking grain, so I was not about to go back and try. You know, 6 months previous, I was, you know, I ate oatmeal just fine, the gluten-free oatmeal just fine. It happens time and time again. When somebody starts getting the hardcore symptoms of celiac disease, they'll give up only wheat, and they'll feel good for about 4 months, and then all of a sudden, they can't eat any grains at all. You know, 90% of celiac people are like that, probably 100%. Okay, so that's why I'm pissed the fuck off, because I should be able to eat rice, I should be able to eat corn and oatmeal and all other fucking grains, if you listen to the fucking propaganda, which is nothing but fucking propaganda. And I went and recently looked on the celiac forum, and this I think it was a guy, I'm pretty sure the handle was a guy. And he's like, oh, I was just diagnosed or whatever. And, but I ate some Udi's. I ate some Udi's bread. And the next morning, like, oh my God, my stomach. The reason why that motherfucker is having pain in his stomach is from the fucking rice gluten. That's why. From the rice gluten. And yeah, I'm about to go back on there. I'm gonna sign. I don't know. They have a different way of... I was able to get on it at work, and I don't know. They always fuck everything up and change everything. But tomorrow, I'm gonna try to get on there, that forum, and I'm gonna tell that guy. And I think I'm gonna cuss and everything. Of course, I'll be thrown off. But no, actually, no, it wouldn't even. Yeah, because those dumb cunts, they're fucking... those moderator dick fucks, they're, that's right, they'll screen the, but anyway, but at least I could shove that comment up his ass, you know what I mean? At least his, I mean, at least he'll read it, but then he'll, you know, ban it before it gets to the forum, but anyway, I will. But I'm still gonna do that sometime this weekend. Okay, so anyway, so, yeah, pardon my French. Okay, so, but yeah, and then the stupid fucks, after, you know, all these moderators and the other people, they'll be like, well, what'd you have with it besides the bread? And then he'll be like, oh, I ate this gluten-free blah, 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 blah sauce, and blah, 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 blah. And then finally, one of the moderators said, oh, well, oatmeal, some people, you know, might be sensitive to the avenin or whatever that's in oatmeal, ovenin or whatever it is, the gluten that's in oatmeal, but still, I'm thinking, you dumb fuck, you're kind of getting to the right comment, but the right comment is, it's rice, you dumb fuck, it's the gluten in the fucking rice, bitch. Okay, so anyway, Yeah, I'm about to fuck them up tomorrow. Okay, so anyway. So yeah, so there was all this freaking rice, like all kind of like growing at, it was weird. I don't know how the aliens do it, but they make everything look so real and normal. And I mean, I don't know. I mean, they can create anything. Like how the fuck is it, you know, in this dimension, a human gonna create a fucking plant pot, you know, with, you know, all these beautiful flower, colorful plants with fucking all this rice, you know, growing out of it or whatever. Only an alien could do that. Yeah, so anyway, oh, I'm sorry, baby. Well, hold your ears, honey, hold your ears. Okay, so, yeah, and so I told that woman, I was like, oh, shit, you know, they're not serving us that rice, are they? And she's like, oh, no, that's just a display of flowers. That's non-edible stuff. And like I say, there was, like, a windowsill over here. But anyway, so if you know any motherfucker that has celiac disease, you know, or that's, you just been diagnosed, any celiac that still gets sick all the time, blah, 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 you need to tell them you can't eat any grains, and it's not that fucking hard to do. I mean, at first, it might seem kind of hard, at first, for some people, but for me, it really wasn't that hard at all, and especially now when I can eat all this shit, it's not hard at all. So yeah, tell them they can't eat any grains, not even the naturally gluten-free grains. I wouldn't even eat buckwheat. Buckwheat is not even a grain. I looked it up. But, I mean, I wouldn't eat anything with the word wheat in it. I mean, it clearly has, and if I ate it, I probably wouldn't have a reaction because it's not a grain. Buckwheat is not a grain. I forgot what it is, but it is not a grain. Because I was shocked that this woman would put buckwheat in one or two of her items. She has buckwheat. And I looked it up, and it is not a grain. It is not a grain whatsoever. but I forgot what it is, but it has that word in it. I would not eat anything with that fucking word in it to begin with. And none of this shit. It was only like one product that she makes that has buckwheat in it. I can't remember the product. But anyway, they're just some, you know, dumb motherfuckers on these forums. Yeah, and this woman that I work with, Ashley, she says she gets on, she's type 1 diabetic. She says she gets on some forums sometimes for type 1 diabetics. And there's dumb motherfuckers on there too. Obviously, people that don't know shit about type 1 diabetes. They're obviously type 2 diabetics. Or just some dumbasses. And they were trying to tell her to go paleo. You know, trying to go paleo. And, well, oh, if you're type 2 diabetic, yes, that will cure those dumbasses. Type 2 diabetics, if you went paleo, yes, you would be cured from type 2 diabetes. But they fucking won't. They're just going to sit there and eat sugar all fucking day long and McDonald's all day long. They all do. Okay, what else was I going to say? But yeah, type 1 diabetics, even if she ate a steak, nothing but a steak, she still has to give her a little bit of insulin because they do not produce, you know, any insulin at all. But they're just some dumbass people on these forums, if you know what I'm saying. They're just people that have nothing fucking better else to do except yap about stupid shit they don't know about on forums. Myra! Okay, so, yeah, what else was I going to say about, paleo, but yeah, I mean, they type 2 diabetic, they may not, you know, be able to eat a whole bunch of fruit, possibly, but, I mean, cheese, beef, well, cheese isn't paleo, but, I mean, if they're not allergic to cheese or whatever, they can eat a bunch of cheese, you know, beef, vegetables. They should take out all the grains, you know, because grains are just bad for everybody. But yeah, if they went paleo, their type 2 diabetes would be 100% fucking cured. And two, like, you'll go to the hospital and there's one whole freaking floor or one whole single wing of the floor, and it's nothing but people that have just gotten their fucking arm chopped off, their foot chopped off, their leg chopped off. I think it's mainly type 2 diabetics. I'm not sure about that one, but I got the impression that it's mainly type 2 diabetics that get their foot chopped off. It might be type 1 too, I don't know. It was just a gut instinct that I had when I was always taking my friend to the hospital because she was hardcore alcoholic. And she detoxed at the hospital about, you know, twice a month. I'm sure she's ran up millions and millions and millions and millions and millions and millions and millions of dollars. But, you know, Social Security paid for it all. But, and I was walking around, and that was before I was 100% enlightened. But I started walking around the other side, the other wing of the floor of the hospital, and I just started looking at the people in the rooms, and it was all of them had their foot chopped off or whatever, their head chopped off, whatever, because of diabetes. Oh, and also she roomated with one time when I took her to the hospital, and that was that same. And that was the same time, as far as I remember, because I went to see her, you know, like 3 or 4 days in a row. And that was, you know, the same floor and everything with all the diabetics that had their foot chopped off or whatever, or leg chopped off. And she roommated with the woman that was about to have her foot chopped off, but she didn't have it happen yet. Okay, so Christy was in this bed and her roommate, and she looked about, at least six, well, she looked like she could have been 70, but she may have been 65, 68. And she told us she was about to have her foot chopped off because of diabetes. And as far as I remember, it was her left foot, you know, about 7 inches up, 7 inches up all the way down to her foot. It was all going to be chopped off. What's it called? I forgot what it's called. What's it called when you have your amputated? Yeah, so, but she hadn't had it done yet. And she did start talking a little bit about her condition, about diabetes and blah, 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 blah. And, I remember her saying, like, she wished she ate better or something like that. So then it was like 2 days later, the next day again, I don't think she had it. She didn't have it chopped off. It was like the third day I went to visit Christy right here. Christy. And then all of a sudden she already had it done. And, and after she already had it done, she was in like a couple rooms down. And at that time, this bed was empty. And all I could hear was like her screaming and shit and that. And that it was either a room down or a couple rooms down. I kept hearing her scream because she kept having like phantom pain or whatever, or not necessarily phantom pain, but I guess, I mean, that would be kind of painful, you know, having your fucking foot chopped the fuck off. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, now that was before I was like 100%. That was like in 2012. I would never set foot into a hospital now, but I knew it was like all horrid and stuff, but when you're not fully enlightened yet, you don't realize just 100% how fucking horrid and how fucked up that is, you know, and, you know, like what a fucked up world we live in, you know what I'm saying? And like I said, I went down that one wing in the interim over these 3 or 4 days that I went to visit Christy. And I noticed all of them, they were all amputees from fucking diabetes. I don't know. I get the impression it's mainly type 2 diabetics that get amputated. But I could be wrong. And maybe 50-50. I don't know. But what else? Yeah, okay. So basically, that's the moral of the story. Well, thanks for listening.